patience. Amen. And there are other counties that they stop people from worshiping Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. You mention the name of Jesus, it's a crime. And you have the authority to stand up and rise up, because this is your time. I don't know how many more years, I don't know when, that the whole world will come against the Prince of Peace. The whole world nail him to the cross. That's include you and me. We are the one that nail Jesus Christ to the cross. The churches, we are the one that nail Jesus Christ to the cross. The Manua, King Herod, represent the Manua. They are the one that killed Jesus Christ to the cross. Pontius Pilate, represent the government. The government nailed Jesus Christ to the cross. None of us is free. And the Bible says when you come and surrender your life to the Lord Jesus Christ, and then you can be saved. Because the wrath of God will come one day for those that crucify him. Amen. That's include you and include me. Few things I want to share. Number one, two, three. Number one, I will read Luke chapter 9 again. When Jesus called the 12 together, he gave them the power and the authority. Number one, to drive out demons. Say with me, drive out demons. The authority that you have for you to drive out demons. It's not a demon living in a tree. Not a demon that you know them by name. There are other evil spirits. We can call them anger, drunkenness, stealing. Amen. The Bible says you have the authority to cast out demons. I remember I was invited to a home back in Nandi, because two young girls, about 2 o'clock early morning, evil spirit come into them. And the same evil spirit, the same name. I don't know whether it's the same evil spirit or not, but the same name go into these two young girls. Maybe they are 16, 17 or 18. Every night they were attacked by evil spirit. They shake and they start to say foul language, and they very rough, and even men and women can't hold them down because of the evil spirit. I was invited to come, so I came with a few boys. We were fasting and praying, and we received that call. We came into this house, about 5-6 strong men holding one girl, Angolila, thin young girl. But when she moved, all these men fell because the power of the evil spirit. Same with the other girl. I stand there. As I look around, I saw the lemon leaf. I saw the woody leaf. I saw a lot of salt on the mat. And I said, leave her. Release her. Hallelujah. I felt that I was full of Holy Ghost. Fasting and prayer. When you fast and pray, Holy Ghost will descend on you. Amen. I stood there and I said, in the name of Jesus, get out of their life. Poof. That first girl fell to the ground, or to the house. And the next girl. And they went to sleep. Like the evil spirit departed. Little I realize it's written in the Bible that we have the authority to drive out demons. Hallelujah. You don't ask the demon to go, you drive them out. Your driving means kick them out, chase them out, cast them out in Jesus' name. It is your duty as a Christian walking with power and authority. Hallelujah. Amen. Turn to your neighbor and tell your neighbor, just move closer so I can drive out some spirit in you. Hallelujah. You know, most of the time, we think that a demon will come with all those ugly pictures that we have in our mind. No. Evil spirit that come to you very sweet can take you anywhere because you don't discern. You cannot discern the work of the evil spirit. Sometimes the work of the evil spirit, when you are fasting and you break fast because of the evil spirit. Because the evil spirit knows when you are fasting, it strengthens your walk with God. A lot of churches, they don't believe in fasting. But Jesus said, to drive out demons, you need prayer and fasting. Amen. Amen. If you want to drive out demons, prayer and fasting. No prayer, no power. Less prayer, less power. Hallelujah. See, the evil spirit are having a field day in the world today because people are not praying and are not fasting. If we calculate the time that we spend in our churches, 1 hour preaching, maybe 1 hour praise and worship, maybe another hour listening to testimony and items. How many hours as a church in a day or in a week we spend on our knees and asking God? Hallelujah. And I believe this ministry was so powerful when it started back in 2002, 2003, 2004. Because most of this mission team, they are now pastors. We spend hours and hours and hours on top of a mountain called Red Rock back in Nandi. And we pray and pray and pray and pray and pray and pray. More prayer, more power. So when people ask, who is this man called Atu? Where is he's coming from? Well, what education he received according to biblical college? I said, none of those education system to learn the Bible. No, it's more prayer that brings more power. Hallelujah. So if you want to walk with power and authority, you need to come on your knees and pray. Say with me, pray. And pray, say with me, pray. And pray, and pray, and pray. Because if you don't pray, you will play. A lot of people are backsliding, or when they meet with a temptation, or when they met the mountain of their life, they are quick to go back into the world because no power. I remember when I used to play rugby. You see my size, the size of someone who will never wear a number 6 or number 7. But that is my position, number 7. And I play with Nandi, play along with Nandi people, and they are very aggressive on the field, especially if they know that you are from other province. But I do my homework. I train. I do a lot of training. In the morning, even during my lunchtime, even in the evening, I train and train and train. Even though I was small, I feel I have the power to go through tackles. I feel I have the power to last the 80 minutes of a game. I feel I have a power, even though I'm not from Nandi, when I go to Prince Charles Park, I can face people from Nandi in whatever village because I feel I prepare my physical body well. And most of the time, if I go outside, they have to take me on a stretcher. I will not walk outside. Why? I built in me that the confidence and the determination. Why? Because of running in the cane field when the sun is hot. Going to the gym. Hallelujah. Not going to the ground and play touch rugby for 30 minutes. And you expect to go to the ground and last for 80 minutes, contacts, tackles, and be tackled? No. It's the same as when you come to the things of God. Hallelujah. If you want the prayer to cast out demons, and when you lay your hands and the people receive healing, you need to go into power practice. Say with me, power practice. Yeah, don't tell your neighbor and tell your neighbor, you look like you have a lot of power. Can I smile then? Hallelujah. Kebaka, I receive it in Jesus' name. Kebaka, zakan diletuk. Ondo kai bagale mushinro ni koko koto koko to koko to to kani. Konge expecta kana tomata mera vagambuta na kago vuno taka. No, you go into your room and start that engine, and you pray and pray and pray. Read the word, pray. Read the word, pray, and ask God to intervene into your life and to change you and to mold you and to build you up. So when you come out of that room, you become a powerful warrior of God. Not just mingle around and muck around. Joshua one time told me, "Pa, we go to town and muck around." Not just muck around, muck around, muck around. And you expect power to fall on your life. We have to do our homework. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. God has given us the power and authority to drive out demons. You know, demons are real. Amen. Most of the time, even from our forefathers, hey, sing na teboro. Na teboro nga po sa tigo, kahit tigo sing na teboro. As the angels are real, because they were angels before they become evil spirit, yes? One third of the angels were cast down with Lucifer. That means they are real. If the angels are real, evil spirit real. If the Holy Spirit is real, then the evil spirit is real. So get real. Get real when you worship God. Amen. I shaken with one of my tabale years back, and I feel in his hand, you know, that scale. Nakanikani. And I know him because he's a preacher. I said, "What do you preach when you have the scale on your hands? Because you cannot give something you do not have. You can't release the power and the anointing and the revelation of God to people when you are spending a lot of time mucking around on the tanoa." Amen. Walking with God is supposed to be real. We'll face with difficulties. We'll face with challenges. We'll face with a mountain. So get real. Tell your neighbor, get real. Hallelujah. Every Sunday we go to church and we listen to sermon and we listen to nice hymn, lullaby, hymn book. No, it's a war. It's a battle. This is a battle. When you receive Jesus Christ as your Lord, as your Savior, the Bible says, when you receive Jesus as your King, you become a member of God's army. So you are fighting when you are here in this world. Not a physical fight, but a spiritual fight. So you need to be strong spiritually. Praise the Lord. And most of us Christians, we are not a good example to the people out there, because one time we stand, but most of the time we fall. The same Christian that they sing in church, the same Christian they lead to work every morning. Yes? The same Christian that they say about Jesus, the same Christian they are playing up at work, getting lazy. How can we be a powerful instrument of God to establish his kingdom in this world and the extension of kingdom when we are not powerful as a witness, as a testimony? Amen. Some of us pastors, when we are full time, we feel self-pity. Oh, I was going to go to the Raka. Hey, you are depending on the physical thing. It does not matter whether you work or not. What matters is your faith in God. Number two, the power that God has gave us is the power over disease and sickness. Say with me, disease and sickness. The Bible says in Mark chapter 1 verse 34, when Jesus healed many who had various diseases, he also drove out many demons But he would not let the demon speak because they knew who he was. Huh? The demon knows who Jesus was. So when you come and become a Christian, it's not a social organization. The church is an army. It's not an RKS old boys or ACS old girls. We meet every Sunday and just have food and talk about everything. The church is an army, a battalion, making changes, impacting the society. Deuteronomy 7:15, the Lord will keep you free from every disease. He will not inflict on you the horrible disease you knew in Egypt, but he will inflict them on all who hate you. Praise the Lord. Go na kambi mbiki na mukaku ni ndoza tendo na tamata nikalo. I have a lot of testimonies of men, so-called men of God, get sick and died because they speak negative against the church. I have witnessed. Hallelujah. We heard the testimony today, the gymnasium, the yacht that got burned in Savu Savu, the owner, the things that he has to do to ridicule the church of Jesus Christ. What happened? Something happened. And the yacht got burned. And the husband and the wife died. It was a news in Fiji a few months ago.